Between Bhutan and Bangladesh in northeast India is the state of Meghalaya, a place of great natural beauty and ecological importance. A place where it is not unusual to meet an elephant on your way to work. A place where choices must be made concerning traditional and modern ways of life. Here in this remote hilly tribal region, one ethnic group, the Garo, have begun to show how important rural communities are when they take the lead in mitigating and adapting to climate change. The Garo Hills presents a verdant landscape, blessed with abundant water, fertile soils, and a benign climate, home to more than 1 million people, the region is also one of the few remaining areas where it is possible to find top predators, leopards, elephants, and biodiversity of all kinds.
Ya selvagri songni asong ya ya ko chengo a ambia chima cham pha ke chamram ino songdong a cha chengo a ye songni mandirang a ya songni song songnok ke par a anchi boli oni mon iko mania presi manias mania changan chi nino thotsa Pakti rabar abai songtap kerkerti donen tak sih yadi bangar. Tahu di mana jaduk? Tahu di mana songsar ken dong jaduk na? Kristen orang ni pun mana?
These villagers' ancestors have lived in and preserved these forests for thousands of years. Their traditional religion worshipped the spirits in all living things. Their legends reinforced a sense of wonder and awe about the forest. Generation after generation have loved the beauty of the natural environment and realized that it provided their food, their water, their shelter, everything that they needed in their lives. One of their neighbors is especially appreciative. Elephants are indigenous to this region. This is perfect elephant habitat. The Garo Hills has well over 1,000 elephants, one of the highest concentrations of wild elephants in India. To have such a high density of megafauna is relatively rare in modern times and suggests a natural system of very high ecological function.
We consider elephants to be architects of the habitat. They change the habitat by their feeding, by their just movement. They open new paths for other animals to follow, and by their dung. There's a number of animals, insects and others that survive on elephant bolus, on the dung.
Elephants and people have coexisted in the Garo Hills for as long as anyone can remember, and both are integral parts of the natural system here. For the people, yet another symbol of the health and wealth of the region's ecology has been the existence of another primate in the forest, the Hoolock Gibbon. There is sufficient data to state that a clear trend exists showing a marked decrease in the number of gibbons in the forest.
The gibbon population throughout India is declining at a very alarming rate. In the last 3-4 decades, nearly 75% decline in gibbon population has been reported. Through numerous surveys, reports, and repeated studies, it has been found that the gibbon population in Garo Hills is also declining, perhaps not at the same rate as the rest of the country, but definitely it's very critical and it is very detrimental for the survival of the gibbons.
The fact that the local people revere the animal suggests that this is a fairly reliable indicator that the ecosystem is deteriorating. Traditionally, the type of agriculture practiced here has been to slash and burn the hillsides, known as jhum cultivation.
The method of jhuming is basically just a slash during the winter season and then let it dry. And then during March and before the onset of the monsoons, it is burnt. And on the very first rains, the seeds are planted and then the production starts.
The first year provides a relatively good yield, but with each crop, the productivity decreases.
Generally, a good jhum cycle is between 10 to 15 years. But here in Garo Hills, since the jhum area is decreasing, they are jhuming the same area in a shorter term. So if they jhum the area in a shorter term, the yield is not much. Change is coming to the people of the Garo Hills. They all have cell phones, and the transportation systems have improved somewhat. Electricity is promised at some point in the future. The modern world, with its shiny wrappers and promise of more stuff, beckons. But if the people go to town in search of a better life, they often only find that they don't have the skills needed to compete with the more sophisticated, better educated city people. This often means they end up taking the lowest forms of work, much worse off than they were at home.
I don't know what I'm saying. dung chisam ko tona kata ni ka mane dewa chisam osa mirakku ba gomanda jaluk namani ma kana warang o phangchakke mung mandirang chiring chisam ko khang onin abachani gamun abacha bahar traditionally chengoni nakba niyamang noni mun jatna songna chiring chibisgit pani khonki aro rang khonki na abachang ko yong ode chiring chibisgrang tken aro jamano dirang sudang na namgni dong jawa imung mandang nasiha
Because of the destructive nature of the traditional agricultural practices that threaten this precious ecosystem, there are many individuals and organizations interested in protecting the Garo Hills. The Meghalaya Forest Department, the Garo Hills Autonomous District Council, and the Wildlife Trust of India, known as WTI, with the support of the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, IUCN, are all working together with the local communities to find a sustainable way forward.
The people are already aware that jhumming is no longer feasible because they have seen the production and they can hardly sustain their families. So they are already out for ways and means of other alternatives.
And there is an elephant in the room, as it were. Actually, there are approximately 1,300 elephants in the Garo Hills. When the elephants and the people come into conflict, it is no joke.
Hazalgani chisa November ni chibri tarik Tengni sari car bajiwan, wa anda kepo posta onga, anda kimi dia agesaku watang naga. Ang ni mandini bimengara to mali menga, aru wa acek jat na patia geta, preng sari car bajiyo ang cia apa ciri bacem, kuni somayo caam kepo rama o krongi mengna ekstin onga ha. Uku angni jakko sija, anga uni siyako dekrekna man paza. Angni zekba natsel kenaja. Natsel kenaja ani gemen ua tos light rangko tek ngen jakal ska. Aro tos light rangko ua atangni jakol nasaan jakal ska ja. Ekbas ua ramarangci jakasi jakra ua nate jakalunga. Wan baksa ua mung makho bia Adita pit cekeng cibungani andalna sekangan ku nekacem. Ndiba mameng dakiba wan wa mungmana biya khatna. Aro redi khatna man srapja. Direk nekanin biya rek srape repme uko gostape gajet cokle.
As tragic as such encounters are, they don't come as a complete surprise.
Tengade wan thanglan nake buru sambo rogani gemen tengara mungmako mungmap mungmang apsan nake janggi thangani gemen tengara apsan wa mungmani dalani ko ba nakaya tengaba burung mat burung baksa janggi thangu ba tengaba kena janggi gna mijagata dokke galango de sooto de
idrang bate mo iye Aro.
India has a population of 1 billion people. And there's a tremendous pressure on the elephant habitat and the corridors. This is the reason why there's an increase in the human-elephant conflict everywhere. And people retaliate to the elephants are very, very serious. Sometimes they poison, sometimes they spear it, sometimes they shoot it. So in order to conserve the elephants, securing elephant corridors are one of the important priority under our project.
Given the lethal nature of some human elephant encounters, the people's tolerance is remarkable.
On the whole, in India, there's great tolerance for animals, for wild animals, and elephant in particular. And as I told you, in the Garo Hills, they have particular fondness for this animal, who they consider almost like an elder brother. You know, they refer to the animal in those terms that they would use for their own brother or elder in their family. So there is no doubt that there is frustration. I think it's more than frustration. Sometimes I'm sure anger, because there's a huge amount of direct damage that the elephant is doing, whether it's crop damage or damaging their houses or even killing people.
The land in the Garo Hills is now like a mosaic with patches of cultivation interrupting the closed canopy of the forest. Everyone wants to find a way forward that is good for the people and good for the animals.
We are working in close coordination with Wildlife Trust of India regarding the elephant projects. So our main idea is to create a corridor or a passage for elephants to traverse from one forested area to the next. So basically in between we have several villages and jhum plots. Whichever is the general path taken by the elephants, we try to secure these paths by having an agreement with the villages, by creating such corridors as village reserved forests.
As human population has grown and pressure on the natural habitat has increased, it's become more and more urgent to find ways that both protect the needs of the people and preserve nature.
Over the years, what we find is that the people, the villagers, are so, very eager to come forward in preserving their, patch of land for, conservation and for the elephants. And all they require is, in turn, some sort of incentive. And rightly so, because otherwise it would have been a jhum area, which is productive for them. But they are giving a portion of their productive land for conservation works. So it's a great thing.
Aro itchnga dura khalakko songni ya komti holo ari japni kemen jin saro ya ari japko dona ha sa songna ba pa chatana man jwa aro ya ko dona ode dijang sujang ma ko dona gen ma ko pengen chinya dokte chono rogen gaba ma sino wachim aro ya nakino abong a mandirang ni kenani ba bong wa chukona wa ari jap dona ode aba chatana de man jwa ya arang de Golmenu Jawa, Anti Sungna Nuknan, Jatna Sungar Puna Katepnan, Gabatala Daniran Konim.
Tingo Tangi Tangan et Solan de Mamung Badam Jawa. But now my bono stop doing about Bambata or Pista or Pisselu Mandram. Megamati Agan getting never Balbalade. Nashima Made, but it ever developed Kahatum. Niva Nashiman Daksa, I am Katasum Aero. Niva.
Without alternatives to the traditional agricultural practices, it is hard for the people to survive, let alone consider animal habitat or conserving natural ecosystems.
The location of this village is crucial because it links other chunks of forests with this major chunk biosphere reserve called Nokrek. So which is why this is not only
important as a catchment, but also as a link to the biosphere reserve. Is a crucial corridor for the elephants.
Actually, people around the world are depending on people like the Garo to protect their forests, because this is the best way to absorb carbon from the atmosphere and naturally regulate the Earth's hydrology, weather, and climate.
Rijab kodis kanchu ni forest ni agantalata ni khoma ni chinga ye rijab ko donia adona chanchiha aro chanchim ya meeting ko chukhatna da songni nokni mandirang plakan aro chiring chibis ko rijab na dona nanga nim janma namne ki songmu nokmu khomongi nangrami kamko meeting ko chukhatna da meeting ko kha.
Kalakai is not the only community that has decided to create village reserve forests. This project has already stimulated the creation of 9 reserves, and many more communities are now positively considering this option. Although the communities are making decisions about their lands, they are receiving incentives to do so. These include capital investment and technical support. The Wildlife Trust of India asked the local people what type of support they would like to receive. Sometimes this is very specific. The Aratika community asked for a motorboat.
Menake songmul kon namblongen namgine ungjok bisong yareng ngani ngun daude si jok jan gemon khali arte kan si jos jakhlai kor yareng dongo de bajal rang rio ba songnyok ti mande sio sane ba bia dongo ogmok na altwe jangi thanunga simen rang sauba sarade salenga negemon.
Nina ba mahari takbarang, orang tangka, heno ba kaparo.
Harana salgaba de mija simen salgaba mangsan ko. Changsa. Oba thangka mangsan ko jangade.
People who have been living by slashing and burning the forest have limited employment skills. But one thing they can do is plant trees. These forested areas are simply wonderful and open up the possibility of ecological tourism, which allow others to enjoy these beautiful areas and provide a potentially large alternative livelihood for forest communities. By voluntarily choosing to set aside land for village reserve forests, the Garo are doing something of immense value. They're helping to maintain elephant habitat and corridors, and they're ensuring that the water cycle is protected, reducing the threat of flooding and drought. And through photosynthesis, they're ensuring that carbon is being absorbed by the enormous amounts of vegetation that grow in the natural forests. What sort of world do we want? Do we want clean water, clean air, to live in harmony with wildlife? If we do, we have to consider how to protect and conserve forests and how to support the livelihoods of those who live in and protect the forest. Many people may be talking about the need to take carbon out of the atmosphere, but the communities of the Garo Hills are actually doing it. This model, if applied by thousands and millions of villages around the world, could end deforestation and reverse the trend by restoring vast areas of degraded lands. The world needs to recognize that it is not the bankers, the politicians, or the carbon marketers who can physically mitigate and adapt the earth to climate changes. It is these people. Their contribution is of enormous value and needs to be celebrated, and they need to be supported.